So you may have a general idea of what USB is. It's a little ports on the side of your Mac. But what about all the different terminology thrown around, like USB-A, USB-C, USB 2, USB 3.1? What does all that mean? Well, it can get a little confusing. So let's first start looking at the physical type of connectors. Now, the one over here you may be very familiar with. It's pretty much synonymous with USB, this type of connector. And it's called the USB-A connector. And it's the one that you most commonly see, at least up until now. You use it to connect all sorts of things to most Macs, like keyboards, hard drives, printers, all sorts of things. And it's got this kind of rectangular shape. And it can be frustrating because sometimes you plug it in and you've plugged it in upside down and you have to turn it around to go right side up. Now there's a second type here that's not pictured called USB-B. And it has a port connection that looks like this. It looks like kind of a square with two little angles here at the top. You usually see this in the same cable as a USB-A. USB-A on one side and then USB-B on the other. And the B side plugs into something like, say, a printer or a scanner or some other device. This was a standard for a long time, so you could determine which side of the cable plugged into the device and which side plugged into your computer. So that's A and B. Now in addition to that, a bunch of smaller versions of USB were developed. For instance, this one here is called the USB Mini. And it was developed to be able to plug USB into small devices like cameras and phones. After a while this evolved and they decided to come up with an even smaller one that worked a little bit better called micro USB. And the micros are very common now. You still see them on a lot of phones and a lot of different devices, Bluetooth headsets, all sorts of things. So typically you have a cable that one end is this and the other end is the USB-A. But now everything's kind of shifting over to USB-C, which is this new connector that's kind of got this rectangular connection with curves. It's not as small as the micro, but certainly nowhere near as big as the USB-A. And it's on all the new MacBook Pros and the MacBook. Also, you're going to see this on a lot of cell phones. A lot of Android cell phones are already using this as their standard connector. One of the cool things about this is you can plug it in either way. It doesn't matter. There's no upside down way to plug this in. And also supports some of the latest stuff. So you've got these different types of connectors. What does it really mean? Because you probably heard terms like USB 2, USB 3.1, that kind of thing. Well, it turns out that's independent of the connector type. So you've got these connector types here, the physical connector, and then you've got things like whether or not it's USB 1, 2, 3, or 3.1. So think of these kind of as speeds. They're also a little bit of capability, but USB 1 was the original USB and it really wasn't fast enough for much more than, say, plugging in a keyboard or a mouse. There were some small devices like little hard drives you could use with USB 1, but it was very slow. You also plugged in a lot of early digital cameras with USB 1 and it would take a long time to transfer your photos across. USB 2 greatly improved that speed by a huge factor, so that you could actually transfer data from USB hard drives, from cameras, and sync your phone much quicker than with USB 1. Now, both of these typically used the old USB A and B connectors and also the micro connector. But whether or not they used those didn't change the speed. It was still either a USB 1 connection or a USB 2 connection. And there was always the bottleneck. If your Mac only supported USB 1, for instance, but you had a device that supported USB 2, everything was at USB 1 speed. Likewise, if you had a device, like say a camera, that was only USB 1, but your Mac was USB 2, everything still was USB 1 speed. It was whatever the fastest. If you wanted USB 2 speeds, you had to have both a device and your computer that both USB 2. Now, another huge leap forward came with USB 3, which was much faster than USB 2. Lightning fast. Matter of fact, today you should never try to buy anything that's USB 2 anymore. Always buy things like hard drives and such that are USB 3 because it's much faster. Even if you have an older Mac that's only working with USB 2, it's great to have USB 3 devices so that in the future when you get a new Mac, you would be able to use them at full speed. And then there was the jump to USB 3.1, which doubled the speed of USB 3. So you have four different speeds here. And these were largely independent of the type of device. But about the time that we started using USB 3.1, we also started using USB-C as the main connector. Now there's a lot of compatibility with these. You can get little converters, pretty cheap, that go, say, take a USB-C device and allow you to plug it into an older Mac with USB-A connectors. And you can also just get simply a different cable, because most of the time when you're connecting a device to a computer, you're using a cable that has a certain type of USB on one end and a certain type on the other. For instance, it may have a micro on one end, say the camera that you're connecting, and the USB-A on the other. In that case, if you get a new Mac that's got USB-C connectors, it's just a matter of getting a cable that's micro to USB-C and tossing the old cable that went to USB-A. Likewise, you could just get a cable, or an adapter rather, so you can go micro to USB-A and then get an adapter to take this to USB-C. But that's not really necessary. You can just get a new cable if you want. Now, that's all fine, but what about Thunderbolt 3? Because you've probably heard about the fact that the new MacBook Pros have these USB-C connectors that accept Thunderbolt 3. What is the deal with that? Well, these Macs here, you can see here on a MacBook Pro with a touch bar, it's these USB-C connectors here, and they're very smart connectors. You can plug into them a device that is a USB device, and these will work like USB ports. But you could also plug into them a Thunderbolt device. Thunderbolt's a competing protocol to USB, and you can have things like cameras and hard drives and all sorts of things that are Thunderbolt, not USB. But these ports don't care. They'll detect what the device is and it will go into your computer as either Thunderbolt or USB. Doesn't really matter. You don't have to worry anymore about, are you plugging the right type of device into your Mac, or are you plugging it into the right type of port. These ports accept Thunderbolt and accept USB. So it's really nice to know that you can use just about anything. You can go all the way back to any of these speeds. You can go to any of the different types of connectors. If you have, say, an old keyboard that uses this type of USB, you can get a cable that goes to USB-C, plug it into your MacBook, and it should work. So that's the deal with these new USB-C connectors on a Mac. They're not just USB-C connectors. They're USB-C connectors that accept Thunderbolt 3 as well as USB connections. So they're kind of like super connectors that can accept any kind of thing, even though they're shaped just like USB-C connectors. As a matter of fact, there is no shape for a Thunderbolt 3 connector, because all Thunderbolt 3 ports are basically just these smart ports that are shaped like USB-C, can accept USB, and can accept Thunderbolt 3 devices.